Now there is a grizzle there. Where'd that grizzle come from?
All right, welcome back. Just took them out for a quick toss, but see these pigeons here? I don't think they're mine because there's two grizzles in there. So very interesting. I took them out for a quick toss early morning. Finding it early morning is a little bit better. All my birds, I believe, are in. I still feel like there might be one or two of my pigeons in that group because otherwise they wouldn't be hanging around like that. There's quite a lot of coloured pigeons in there, which is interesting. There is a mealy there, so I wonder if that's mine. Come on. I don't want them flying around like this because I guarantee you the falcons will hit them in a minute, and I don't want them to be my birds. But if that was me, I'd be a little bit annoyed that my toss pigeons have come so far off course because I don't live near other races. I'm way out of the way. Like, pigeons don't come out here unless they're way off course. So similar size flock to mine, I'd say, probably a little bit smaller. But yesterday my birds done the same thing. They actually dragged pigeons all the way out here. It's 15, 20 kilometers almost off course from most other people, which is interesting. I don't know if that's the brainwashing technique that's really driving home for my birds, but I don't know. But we're definitely dragging a lot of people's pigeons where they shouldn't be, because look, here all my guys are here. They trap really well. I'll show you all that footage right now.
Split up. This is not a good thing. I bet them back, and these are the first ones back. Definitely not a good sign. Great. This might be a bad toss. I think the falcons have gone through them. Come on. See that pigeon? He landed and went straight under the loft. That's where he lives. I've been trying to break him, but oh well. That's so odd. Where are the rest of them? There's one more coming in singles. This is bad news. Oh no, here they are. Hey, there's a white pigeon in there. That's not mine. Huh, is it a white pigeon? Oh, my mealy hen. No, it's my mealy hen. I got excited. It just looks really white. No, there is a grizzle there. Where'd that grizzle come from? They're not coming down because there's some other pigeons in there. Someone else is tossing as well, I guess. Huh. Imagine if that was Speedy Blue, my grizzle. Can you see it just there somewhere? Ah, oh, it's really hard to tell. I've definitely pulled a grizzle in from somewhere. Come on. See if we can drag them down. Looks like they've intercepted with another group of pigeons. Huh. There's two grizzles in there. And it looks like my pied that I lost the other day is in there, unless if that's mine. But I can't get them down. That's what's happened, I think. It doesn't look like falcons. It looks like they've bumped into another group of pigeons. Mom! Because they definitely still shouldn't be flying. They're going to get smashed in a minute. The falcon's going to take them. Come on! When there's a different colour pigeon in there, I know. Oh, there's the rest of them. Jeez, Christ, look at all these pigeons. They're not on mine. Oh, we've dragged someone's pigeons over, I think. Whoops. Come on. I think that top group's not mine. Because these ones are mine. Look how well they trap. No mucking around here. Come on. Come on. Well, obviously my pigeons must be a little bit better trained than those ones. Man, they're going to get smashed by falcons in a minute. What are they doing?
I had a little group come back first, which I've seen, so I just left one tray available, but I'll put all trays available now. I'm just gonna go watch these pigeons because I would like to try and trap some of these colors and see. I'm still a little kid at heart when it comes to this. I still love trapping stray pigeons, and looks like they might have gone. Well, it is that time of year where everyone's going to be tossing every single day to try and catch up, because the season's been a bit later, so people are working pretty hard to get their birds back on track, but looks like those are gone. Well, that's probably a good thing. I don't want the falcons hanging around, especially if we've got a couple of birds that might come back late. We don't want those to get snapped up, because we've been copping it pretty hard. I did do a toss yesterday, and all my mealy hens in there too. So they weren't my birds at all. Looks like I've got all my birds here. But we did do a toss yesterday morning as well. I didn't film that. Pretty early like this, same time. And the birds come through really quick, no problems. Bet me home. These are a little bit slower, but looks like they were tied up with some other birds. So I'm pretty happy. I'd still say there's a couple more to come back. Maybe they are in that flock, but we'll just wait and see. I'll do a head count when they all settle down. Right, for some reason my audio didn't want to work, so we're going to have to voice over a lot of this. Check that out. Birds have had a bath, looking pretty good. So I'm keeping them on a Sunday only at the moment. Just have a bath and just relax. But that's what I want to see, nice and healthy. Basically, my race videos from last year, I didn't put them together in a compilation like I did in 2022. So there will be a video up in the next few days of the 2023 season. We only get to a few races a year due to work commitments, family, and getting absolutely slaughtered by falcons. We run out of birds pretty quick and my time is minimal. So we'll go through, basically all the birds are back. Yesterday's toss and today's toss, we've got 100% returns from that. Today was interesting. Both days brought home a lot of strays. Today we brought home someone's race team, so the birds are really locked into where they need to be going and not to be swayed by other birds, and that's one of the main reasons for this brainwashing technique. And today was a perfect example. Basically, my birds got mixed up into other birds, quite a lot of birds too, and race birds that are out being trained, and they dragged them 15, 20 kilometers off course. They didn't follow those birds, so that's a positive thing for me. I think that the brainwashing techniques are working. And basically, we'll quick have a look at the two injured birds. So basically, the piecock bird, I think that he won't make the season at this point in time. He is alive and he's doing quite well, and we'll put the video footage up because it just didn't record before. But we'll see how he goes. We'll heal him up, we'll get him back in, we'll put him in with some really, really young birds so that he can heal up and take his time. And then we can probably get him out flying again, but I really don't know how he'll go. It's chest injuries, no wing injuries, so he might actually heal up pretty quick. But like I said, he's eating, drinking really well, so it's not a huge problem. And we've got the little hen in there as well, and she is actually just a little bit of a ding on the wing. But I think she'll be fine. I reckon she might even make the race season because it was only a light scratch, but they're both in that little box and they're doing pretty well. So we'll see how they go. I'll keep you updated on it. I'm happy to get birds home because otherwise we're losing them. And basically, before we close this out, I'm going to show you what a second place in a final and a third ace pigeon crossed into the seventh place in the final pigeon looks like, because they are looking fantastic. And I actually bred six the same way as this, identical. And they're all at Pattaya now. So I'm very interested to see how those perform in Pattaya. I don't know, who knows, it's all luck, bit of pot luck I guess, but you got to have the right genes there, and these are performing one loft pigeons, so we'll see how we go. But cracking looking little baby. So I'll see you guys in the next video. Things are getting pretty hectic, racing time's coming, and a few decisions in the stock bird side that we really need to make, because I don't want to just feed pigeons for no reason. That's what we're doing at the moment, because we've only got a couple of birds that are producing some really outstanding pigeons. So I want a whole lot full of those kind of birds. See you soon.